Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Harp and Guitar, People and Music. So for today's video, just a real quick one here. I just went to into the city day before yesterday and went and visited a couple of record stores. So I thought I'd share with you real quickly here a couple of really good record store finds that I managed to scare up. First one I was pretty amazed to find, actually, because it wasn't in the blues or jazz section. It was in the folk music section. And that's this two record collection here of Lead Belly. It's actually called the Huddy Leadbetter. That was Lead Belly's real name. The Huddy Leadbetter Memorial Album, Volume 1 and Volume 2. Now, this was a two volume set, obviously, that was pressed and released in 1950 and 1951, respectively. Just a couple of years after Lead Belly passed away. And I thought these were really cool for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's Lead Belly. I mean, he's a legend. Anybody who's worth their salt knows anything about the blues knows about Lead Belly. But the other thing was that the packaging was all the original packaging. This is the original paper label that's just glued, I assume, onto the cover here. Same as this one as well. Okay, so the first one here, this is volume one, and inside, I mean, the photo is the same as the cover of volume two, but it's this cool booklet, and it gives you a brief description of Lead Belly and his life, and then inside are all the liner notes for the songs, the lyrics, and a little bit of a rundown or a synopsis of each song. Some of them just a couple of sentences, but some of them, you know, entire paragraphs. And for a guy like me, that's just icing on the cake. I mean, it was great to find these records, and they're in fantastic condition. Probably because they're not on 78s, on what we call those shellac platters, you know, the very fragile 78s. These are actually on vinyl, and they spin at 33 and a third. So what they did was they took the original Lead Belly pressings, the masters and the mother copies, and then pressed them onto vinyl. They re-recorded them and pressed them onto vinyl, as opposed to those very, like I said, fragile shellac 78 RPMs. So that was fantastic. This is the volume two. As you can see, it's in pretty good shape, you know. A little bit of dust here and there. I've got to take a chamois to it, but other than that, no scratches, no dings. So, this was a huge find for me, and I was barely able to contain myself when the guy said $10 each at the record store. I don't think he had any idea of what he had, because these are first pressings of this, like I said, from 1950 and 1951, respectively. The next item that I wanted to show you, I was almost equally excited to find. And that's this rare import of Big Bill Brunsey. It says, Big Bill Brunsey sings, plays, and talks. But anyway, the first side is just one song. It's actually Big Bill explaining or introducing the song Big Joe Turner Blues. And then he sings the song. And then side two, he sings two more songs, In the Evening and Going Down the Road Feeling Bad, which are a couple of actually classic standards, not only in the blues, but for Big Bill Brunsey himself. Like I said, I was really excited about this one because, again, it's packaged well, so it was well looked after. And it's on a 45 RPM. So, again, it isn't those old 78 RPM shellac records that fall apart really easily if you drop them and they shatter into hundreds of pieces, which often has happened and made me cry. But with these ones, they're a little bit more flexible. Because they're vinyl, so I think that's why I was able to find this thing in such great condition. $20 for that, which may seem a little steep for one tiny little 45 RPM record, but like I said, it's basically a museum on wax here, you know? It's got Big Bill not only singing songs, but explaining or being interviewed about the content of the songs that he sings. So, and I'm a huge Big Bill Brunsey fan anyways. He's a fantastic guitar picker. He's a great singer. So, you know, that was just a great find for me. The next one, and this one only cost me $8. And it's sax greats. Greats of jazz saxophone. As you can see, we've got Stan Getz, Coleman Hawkins, we've got Ben Webster, and look at this special guest, Max Roach. So, you know, not bad. Not bad at all. And I like jazz almost as much as I like the blues. So, you know, again, for me, this was a great deal. And last but not least, again, another import. This is R.B. Stidham. Now, a lot of people will probably say, R.B. who? Who or and what is an R.B. Stidham? Well, R.B. Stidham is a Mississippi bluesman, and he was pretty popular in the late 40s, early 50s. But what caught my attention on this was not only because I was kind of familiar with the name, and I just thought to myself, wow, this is so obscure, I've got to get it. And again, it's an import, so it's some rare stuff. But it's some of the fellas that are backing him up on the record that also attracted my attention. He's got Tampa Red on guitar on many of the songs, playing second guitar because R.B. plays lead guitar. But he's got Lefty Bates, he's got Ransom Knowling, like I said, Tampa Red, so just amazing. And this one I think was $12. $12 for, you know, something as classic blues like this. You know, sort of that just post-war stuff. Just before that sort of Chicago blues sound got really big. Again, you can see the vinyl is in great condition. No scratches or anything on it, so yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. So I think that's going to do it for today, everybody. Just wanted to show here a little bit of some of my record store finds. You know, if you've got the day off on a weekend and maybe it's kind of crappy outside, you know, it's raining or what have you now that summer is finally upon us, maybe it's a good idea to hit a bookstore now and again, but also hit a record store, because you never know what you can find for basically just a few bucks. I think all in with all of this stuff, I'm looking at $45 Canadian. So, you know, it's you can get some great deals, and it's a great hobby, and you're going to constantly be able to keep adding to your blues and jazz music library, and you're not going to be paying a lot out of pocket for it. So get out there and enjoy some of those old record stores and see what treasures you can find when you're searching for the blues. So with that, I think I'm going to wrap it up here. So thanks again for tuning into Harp and Guitar, People and Music. Please, if you haven't already, don't forget to like, share the video, subscribe, and let us know what you think down in the comments below. Take care, everyone. Have a great day. And thanks a lot. Bye-bye.